cemetery here in New Orleans. Can you feel it?
Can you feel it?
I can feel it.
I can feel it.
I'm kind of scared. We have to be very careful what we say because, like, there's a tomb of the voodoo queen here, and this is some scary stuff
Fred
here.
Fred used to date her.
Hmm?
Yeah.
You did do the voodoo queen, didn't you?
Yeah, that was, you know.
So, had her when she
wait. I don't feel right about saying anything bad about the voodoo queen. I never said that, okay? So in a couple weeks, if you hear about some bizarre gardening accident that happened to the members of Cinderella, it's because they said something about the voodoo queen in the cemetery.
People heard you.
In the cemetery.
People heard you.
Anyway, this is the Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball here, and it's in New Orleans, and also, you guys just are finishing your video, which of course we will see very soon on MTV. Tell us about it, will you?
Well, we shot it out in Hollywood, and the video is, we're playing at this telethon that's staged to save rock and roll from the evils of censorship. And
but it wasn't a real telethon.
No, that's just
so basically
the
if you raised
the
money,
video,
you would have kept it yourself then.
No, our manager would have kept it. And we had Little Richard guest starring as the host of the telethon.
And I also understand there were some other celebrity cameos.
Yeah, Dweezil Zappa and Shelley Duvall. And the video is for the song Shelter Me.
Mm-hmm. So how do you feel now? The album is done. Are you satisfied with it? Are you excited about the new album?
I personally feel this is the best one. I like them all, but I think this one is the best one. It's just raw. It's really raw. I think it's the rawest album.
Mm-hmm. Raw.
So the word for the new album is raw.
Raw. As in R-A-H.
Raw. Oh, right.
Raw. When we got together and said, how do we want this produced, we said raw.
Okay, right now let's play some videos, and some of them are even Halloween videos, and some aren't. And some are just equally scary. We're going to have a world premiere from, I think, the new Judas Priest album is one of the best albums he's put out in a long time. We're going to play Evil, plus debuts from one of my favorite bands, Danzig, with her Black Wings. And we've got Electric Boys, Dio, and King's X. But right now, what could be scarier than playing a video by Cinderella? Here's Nobody's Fool.
Ooh.
It's a special Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball, and a long time ago, earlier this evening, Fred said about, we made a comment about him going out with Marie Laveau, who is the queen of voodoo, and right now we're standing in front of her tomb. See, now they're saying these things. I won't say anything in front of her tomb. Has anything happened to you in this past hour since you've said that?
Well, yeah, my hair all fell out, but I had to get, they had glue backstage here, and I got to put it back. But a lot of bad things happened that I couldn't really tell you on camera, but I'd like to point something out. These X's here mean good luck, and they do these, but the very trippy thing there, look at that, see that?
What is this, Fred?
I understand. No, just let me point something out.
Since
here.
I heard that you also, well, this was the tomb of the voodoo queen,
yes,
and weren't you one of the voodoo queens?
Yeah, I was
a different kind of queen.
I wasn't a queen.
What's this?
This right here, I don't know what this symbol is, but I know that's the X for good luck, and that's written in blood, which is pretty trippy, because that's not good. Very.
Tom, do you know whose blood it is?
It's probably going to be one of ours.
They can't really dust for blood.
Could be ours next. You never
know. It's one
of
those things that I think are just better left unsolved.
One of the unsolved mysteries.
It's time for the number 5 Skull Crusher of the Week. You know these guys, so why don't you intro it?
Okay, this is Motley Crue with Same Old Situation.
Things a headbanger ball makes too. Oh, all those socks I lost in the dryer. There they are. We shouldn't be saying these kind of things. They make us stand in front of the Queen of Voodoo's tomb.
But yeah, we keep saying them.
And then we keep on making it important to these people, the risks that we are taking in this life and probably our afterlife. These are scary things. Are you still okay, Fred?
I don't know. I just grabbed for glasses that aren't even on my face.
Whoa, look at that voodoo that you do. Anyway, right now it's time to pick this week's ball buster. Time for you to vote. Time for you to get your say. And this week's winner, last week's winner, is going to go up against Black Sabbath. Feels good to meet Black Sabbath. We're in a cemetery. That's kind of wacky, kind of wild, kind of spooky. And the number that you can call is 1-900-370-0100. Fred, what was that number?
1-900-370-0100.
And how much is each call going to cost them, Tom?
50 cents.
See, they didn't even know that. Some spirit put those words into it. Maybe not even the cue cards behind them. It was a spirit. Anyway, here is last week's winner.
Let's take a look in here again.
Right.
Hi, and welcome back to the Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball. We're here at Marie Laveau's House of Voodoo, and I'm standing here with Rose and Ricky Rackman.
And you also go by the name of?
Miss Black Venus, the Voodoo Priestess.
Okay, tell us a little bit about this House of Voodoo.
This is the authentic house that Marie Laveau, the famous voodoo queen of the 1800s, her daughter lived in this house. And this is a historical spot and a spiritual spot for the voodoo people in this area.
No, go ahead. I'm sorry.
We have voodoo rituals where I dance with the snake. I also have consultations by appointment only, where I can read the tarot cards for a customer or a client. I can consult with the spirits or with the Orisha.
What is that?
The Orisha are Yoruba deities from Nigerian Yoruba tribe.
Now, can you put spells on people?
It's voodoo. Authentic voodoo does not involve spells.
What about voodoo dolls? If there was an enemy, could you use a voodoo doll and maybe bring pain to them or something like that, like voodoo, people think?
Voodoo dolls here in Louisiana, used by Marie Laveau, were used for healing and for special causes where the person probably didn't believe in voodoo, but they needed to be healed. And you couldn't bring the person to the voodoo queen because they were too afraid. So they would use a doll instead. Mm-hmm. So voodoo dolls have many purposes. Mm-hmm. It depends on who's using it and whether or not it's a priest or a sorcerer.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Well, me and Tom are going to go look around for some stuff in here. Right now, it's time to play a video from Dangerous Toys. Here is Scared. Ooh. Ricky Rackman here, Tom Kiefer, and Rose. And we're in Marie Laveau's House of Voodoo in New Orleans for a special Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball.
Now, Rose, I was curious as to what this is in your hand.
It is called by the Yoruba tribe a Shango staff, which is used by priests and priestesses of Shango throughout voodoo here in Louisiana, in New Orleans, and in Africa.
And what is
and
it?
In South America and Brazil.
What is it used for? Do you like wave it at things? Or?
Well, it's used to represent the spirit, the deity, which is a protection against evil and any kind of assaults from your enemies. Things that you would probably want to protect yourself from that are unseen, like evil spirits.
So it's for protection?
Yes, it's mostly for protection.
How about the crystal ball?
The crystal ball is used by trance mediums. A trance medium can see into the future by getting visions through the crystal.
So it is just like you've always heard about the crystal ball, you can actually see?
If you're a trance medium, uh-huh. Then you'll be able to see a vision inside of it. But if you're not a trance medium, it may be very difficult for you.
And you are a trance medium, right?
Yes, I am. Mm. And I can be contacted by someone contacting this shop at the House of Marie Laveau.
In New Orleans.
Appointments only.
Mm-hmm. And I'm just getting a vision right now that it's time for the number 3 Skull Crusher of the Week with the lovely... Everybody's talking about Bobby Brown, the girl in the video. Well, Warrant's also in it. Here is Cherry Pie, the number 3 Skull Crusher of the Week. It's the Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball, and right now we are at Marie Laveau's House of Voodoo. Right?
Right.
Yes.
That's where we are.
This is behind us here. We have a painting of Marie Laveau in her elderly years. The hair there, the snake hair.
What do the snakes symbolize, Fred?
Read the book. No. It symbolizes power.
Power.
And she died when she was 98 years old, and I believe her daughter once lived in this house.
Yes.
Also... We have...
You're just you've got just such a knowledge of voodoo.
Yeah. Anyway, we
wealth
have behind
knowledge.
Here...
A wealth of knowledge.
Wealth of knowledge.
Yes, I am. And this is a fertility doll. Of
Do you use that one?
Yeah. And this is sort of like an altar. Well, it actually...
And there's just tons of alligator heads.
What do you think the alligators are for, Fred?
Just stand right in front of everybody, Fred. Please do it. You know how hard it is to get some good alligator heads these days?
Yeah, that is...
Why don't you tell us what video we're going to show now, Tom?
We're going to show Vinnie Vincent.
I've been waiting to
kills.
See that video. Good. Let's watch it, shall
let's
we?
Let's watch that, shall we?
It's the Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball here in New Orleans with the very talented Tom Kiefer and the funny Fred Corey from Cinderella.
So I amuse you. I'm funny like a clown, right?
Not like a clown. Anyways.
You're going to take that from him?
So I'm here to amuse you.
I didn't see the movie Goodfellas, so I don't get it. But I'll go watch it, and then when I come back and watch it on tape, I'll laugh a lot.
You'll be amused. So.
Anyways, once again, this New Orleans thing,
yes.
The witchcraft, the voodoo, the jazz,
very heavy.
And why are you always drawn to New Orleans? Why are you guys have been here a lot, haven't you?
It's uncontrollable. To me, it's an uncontrollable force.
Do you feel that this is where maybe your spirits are in New Orleans?
No. It's where the band
they are
sends
now.
Me.
I think your spirits are in Beverly Hills, right?
I think so.
Right now, let's play the number two Skull Crusher of the Week. You do good imitations. Can you do a Jeff Tate imitation?
Not on camera.
Not on camera. Here is one of my favorite bands. Here is Queensryche with the number two Skull Crusher of the Week.
Empire.
The Thinking Man's Rock and Roll
what
Band.
What a cool band.
Cool band.
What
you
a
like,
cool
is
band.
Is this a cool band?
Yeah,
they're killer.
We wouldn't lie in a voodoo store.
We wouldn't lie in a
definitely
voodoo store.
Definitely.
It's this very scary show. Woo! We're in New Orleans. It's the third and final hour of the Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball. I'm Ricky Rackman with Tom Kiefer and Fred Corey from the band Cinderella. Tell us some of the scary videos we have coming.
Well, oddly enough, we've got coming up Halloween from Halloween and Motley Crue's Live Wire.
And kids, when you watch that video at home, don't set your legs on fire.
We also have debuts from Danzig, Rhino Bucket.
My favorite band.
And Ricky's favorite band, Danzig.
You do like
Rhino
that band.
Bucket.
Oh, yes.
And King's X. And right now, here's...
Do your Dio voice for us, Fred, please.
Rhino! We have... the debut from Dio, Angel!
It's witchcraft. Hi, Ricky Rackman here with...
Tom Kiefer.
And Fred Corey.
From the band Cinderella. And we're in New Orleans, obviously. And we are standing right outside, about to go in the witchcraft shop. Don't do that.
Sorry.
Now, what is your opinion? How do you feel? Do you believe in witchcraft?
Well, whenever I come to New Orleans, I pick up what I need, for the... next 6 months.
Right.
So
your spells and potions
right here.
Very heavy voodoo guy over here. Uh-huh. Very heavy.
So that's what you attribute your success to?
Definitely.
Definitely.
Well, we were trying to figure it out, and so it's witchcraft. It's witchcraft.
Tom, about how much you make every 5 years? Definitely.
About $100.
About $100.
Well, right now, maybe we can find some candles and potions or something like that to enhance that. We're looking for that candle that improves ratings. But right now it's time to play Halloween or Halloween. Play the song Halloween from Halloween here on Halloween for you. Because it's scary. Because you deserve that kind of stuff.
The voodoo viewer.
It's scary. Ooh, it's getting scary here. So apropos to be here for Halloween. We're in the witchcraft shop in New Orleans. Ricky Rackman with the very evil Fred Corey and his evil twin, Tom Kiefer.
Very scary.
But Tom, you have good luck now. Why is that?
Fred can't scare me because I have my good luck chicken foot.
Mm-hmm. The chicken wasn't too lucky, was it? I don't think so.
No.
Homie, don't play that.
Because he's a one-legged chicken now.
He's a one-legged chicken now.
And the rest they make really special sacred nuggets with, I think, with chicken nuggets. Anyways, but right now it's time for us to play the number one Skull Crusher, which is up two from last week, from the witchcraft shop in New Orleans. Here is AC/DC Thunderstruck.
Aww.
Once again, we are in New Orleans for this Halloween Shocktober edition of the Headbangers Ball with Tom Kiefer and Fred Corey of Cinderella. And right now, once again, we are at the
witchcraft shop.
Uh-huh. The only witchcraft
the only
shop.
Real witchcraft
yeah,
shop.
Yeah, they got tons of them, but...
This is the witchcraft
this
shop.
Is,
there definitely is a feeling here. Don't you kind of agree?
There's a feeling, yeah.
There is a feeling. And this is perfect. I say it on the show all the time, one of my favorite bands. This is definitely one of my favorite bands. And I'm very glad that we're playing this video. And actually, I'm really glad that we're going into this video from this place, because I don't think any place more perfect to debut a Danzig video.
When you're telling a story, Ricky,
yes.
Have a point. It's so much more enjoyable for the listener.
The point is, here is Danzig from his second album, Lucifuge. Here is her Black Wings. Aww. Well, that's it for the Headbangers Ball, the special Shocktober edition, the special
Scary show. Was it scary?
Scary. Scary.
I'm scary.
Very scary.
We don't know if any we got any evil hexes or spells put because of we needed.
You got one.
That girl when she put a chicken foot around.
She was a witch.
A witch put a chicken foot around Tom's neck, and we see he's not wearing it anymore. We don't know if this is good or bad.
We don't know if it's good. It took him 3 hours to figure out if we should take it off or leave it on.
For all we know, when you're watching this, you might only see Fred and myself and just this mic just floating there.
I could be gone. I might not even be here.
Anyway, we had a real good time in New Orleans, and of course, look for the debut of Shelter Me from these guys, Cinderella. She's going to be their new video that we'll be seeing pretty soon on MTV, and keep on watching it because that's where you're going to see it first. What are you looking at?
Just looking.
Thanks. Is it my voodoo aura that I'm giving off?
You're voodooing.
Hey, we had a lot of fun here. Have a good Halloween. And right now, it's time to play a band from Van Nuys. It was formed in 1987 in Van Nuys, where I grew up from a little kid this big to.
But nobody is from California in this band. One guy's from Finland, I think
I think the drummer's from Ireland.
The drummer's from Ireland, the bass player's from the
U.S. We just know this off the top of our head.
We know that.
We have such not only does Fred have a knowledge about voodoo, he knows about Rhino Bucket. And
Rhino
here they
Bucket.
Are with Blood on the Cross. Tonight we're in New Orleans, but I get to go to parties that I otherwise probably wouldn't have been invited to. And tonight is no exception, because tonight the Headbangers Ball is on a riverboat floating down the Mississippi with Cinderella. This is a party for their album Heartbreak Station, which is going to be out in November. So let's climb aboard. Headbangers Ball, I'm Ricky Rackman, and tonight our co-host for this evening in Nolens, is that how we say it?
Nolens
is, of course, the band Cinderella, and they are hosts for this party and my co-hosts for the evening. And we are both on the Natchez Steamboat, right?
Costos. Are you doing the liberal configuration?
And may I add that you are good Costos, too.
The great Costos.
Tom, let me ask you the question. Why in New Orleans?
Look around. I mean, why not? You know?
Good answer, Andy. Would you like to elaborate on that, Jeff? I couldn't have said it better, Eric.
Save words.
Okay, never at a loss for words.
I mean, you let think me just about it, right? Any town, you're going to have a party. Where are you going to have a party?
New Orleans.
Nolens.
Well,
this
coming
to the party capital of the world.
Fred, why don't you tell us some of the videos we have on the way?
Okay, on the way we have Judas Priest, we have Anthrax, we have, that's Eric, this guy, Jeff, that's beautiful, what is that, Velvet? That's his favorite.
I love that.
We have Testament, we have Iron Maiden,
plus debuts
from
Mother Love Bone.
Yeah.
And Slaughtered.
I like that name.
Also, we're going to have the world premiere from some group of swell guys.
Costos
of the evening. We're gonna have the world premiere of their video Shelter Me. But right now, where'd you guys who can speak of you guys? Who hasn't had too many hurricanes?
That's beautiful.
Where did you film this video? Tell us about it. We're gonna play Gypsy Road.
We filmed it in LA.
At a sound
stage. Didn't? No, we didn't.
Gypsy
we did it
Road?
In
oh, Gypsy Road. Oh, in Mexico. I thought it was Shelter Me.
Here it is, Gypsy Road. Ricky Rackman here with Tom and Eric from Cinderella, and we are aboard. I guess tonight the boat is called SS Cinderella, correct?
Tonight it is, yeah.
You did that good. I just want to tell you. You worked the mic perfect. Now,
spontaneous mic control.
See, you weren't doing it just there. You're supposed to be
spontaneous mic control.
This is one thing I want to know. I understand that the mayor or somebody is declaring it Cinderella Day.
Yes, it's true. It's Cinderella Day.
And you guys are getting
Gnarlins.
The key to this city?
Oh, yeah.
Explain that. What does it take to have someone call a day after you?
I don't know, man.
Cinderella Day.
I guess you got to rent a boat and float around in their biggest river.
So that's what it takes? And you guys are getting the key to the city?
Yeah. I don't know what it opens, but we're gonna
I looked
find
there's
out.
A piece of wood attached to it that says men's. So I think that might...
That one was old.
Yes, but there's somebody out there that
actually,
like
it says ladies.
You know what I think it is, actually?
We've been down here so much... in the last couple months recording and doing this party and everything. I think they're giving us the key that to get out.
To get out
they
of
want us
city.
Out of here. Uh-huh.
Right now, it's time to play a video. This is Faith No More Epic Live from their video, You Fat Bastards!
Here it is. What is that, Velvet?
Fat Bastards! See, we're hearing it in the background
in
right
the background.
Now. And I'm digging it, man. And I mean that in a good way. Dear Dick Graves.
Oh, yeah, they're all right.
Ricky Rackman here, the Headbangers Ball, with Fred Corey and Jeff LaBar of the band.
I'm
Cinderella.
Jeff.
I'm Jeff.
No, I'm Jeff.
Oh.
These are the Rodney Dangerfields of Cinderella.
We are the Rodney Dangerfields of Cinderella.
Now tell us.
The Rodney Dangerfield of the rest of the rock world.
We know that. Anyways, we're hearing the album in the background a lot. Just so people know, which it does come out November 20th, let's plug it a couple times.
Yes.
What songs, like, really stand out on the album, in your opinion?
Shelter Me.
Uh-huh.
Is probably, that's the first single, and it's probably the, get out of here.
Yo, Bob, we're on TV.
See, you don't get even respect, even when you're here with the MTV mic.
No respect.
But Shelter Me, I'd say the funk song. What's the name of that?
The what song?
Love's Got Me Doing Time.
Uh-huh. Got Me Doing Time.
There's a lot of different styles.
Tell us about some of these styles real quickly.
Well, it goes from like country and western to funk to like hard rock. To
the
blues,
black,
to blues,
punk,
to rap,
lumbada. And right now, let's all lumbada with the number 5 Skull Crusher debuting on our countdown. You do a good Klaus. Scorpions with.
Hello, California!
Tease me, please me by the Scorpions.